Today I'm going to give you guys 5 things that designers commonly forget when working in Adobe Illustrator. So see how many of these 5 things you have actually forgotten yourself in your graphic design workflow. Yo, what is up people? It's Tom with Satori Graphics, back again with another graphic design tips video. Today I'm going to show you guys 5 things that people or designers commonly forget when working in Adobe Illustrator. So follow along in today's video and see how many of these things you forget or have forgotten on your graphic design projects. Before we start, I quickly want to remind you guys that if you want to help out my channel here at Satori Graphics, head over to my Teespring store and check out my prints and t-shirts that you can purchase to show your appreciation for what I'm doing here at Satori Graphics. Also, if you missed yesterday's video on how to design a logo using the Shape Builder tool, go back and check that out on my channel because there's a really cool video on the logo design process using the Shape Builder tool. The first thing that designers often or commonly forget to do in Illustrator relates to fonts. So when saving your design in Illustrator for print or on a PDF for example, you want the font to be recognized on whatever device it's going to be sent to. The first way to do this in Illustrator is to select the font and then go up to type and create outlines. This is going to essentially turn the font into a vector shape. It's always ideal to save 2 versions of your designs in Illustrator if you apply this method. One design with your font as fonts and the other version as the font being outlined. This is so that you can edit the text at a later date. The other method would be to embed and package the fonts with the design files when you send them for printing. Either way, some designers do forget this little step in the printing process. The next commonly forgotten process in Illustrator relates to strokes. For this example, we're going to look at this logo design here. If you have strokes on your design, you're going to want to need to expand them all. To do this, simply select the object and then go up to Object and Expand. You then need to select the stroke option. We do this because when you send your final artwork for print, you want to minimize the possibility of errors occurring. With the strokes expanded, the client's not going to be able to edit the artwork, but the design can be reproduced and scaled to any size without errors occurring. Like I said in the last point, you should save 2 versions of the artwork, one that you can edit, and then the final artwork which is print ready. The third thing that designers often forget to do in Illustrator relates to colour. For print, most people will save their work as CMYK. This is completely fine in most cases, but again, we want to limit the errors when sending the final artwork to be reproduced globally. We can convert the CMYK colour mode of an object to a universally known Pantone colour. To do this, select the object and then go up to Edit, Edit Colors and Recolor Artwork. Click the icon here and locate the color books and then the Pantone Solid Uncoated. Click OK and Illustrator will then convert a specific object to the closest possible Pantone match. If you now see in the colour window, the colour is Pantone instead of CMYK. The fourth thing that designers commonly forget to do in Illustrator is not paying enough attention to the in-depth quality of a design itself. This logo looks fine from afar, but if I zoom in by pressing Command or Control Plus on the keyboard, you might find some anomalies like this here. We can use the Direct Selection tool to amend the anomalies like so. Also, you may want to select multiple areas of the design with Shift, and then unite them in a Pathfinder window. This gets rid of overlapping areas on your design. Lastly, you can select your design and go up to Object, Path, and Clean Up. This is going to ask Illustrator to check the design or the vector path for areas that can be tidied up. And as you can see here, I don't actually have any areas that need tidying up. And lastly, this is a big one. It's something every single one of us has fallen victim to at some point, and that is not saving your work that often. You must do this because Illustrator could decide to quit on you randomly. But if you do have a decent machine, this is going to be very rare. But the reality is, you never know when it's going to happen, so it's a great idea to save your work every half an hour or so. So there is today's video on 5 things designers commonly forget when working in Adobe Illustrator. Let me know how many of these things you have forgotten in your design workflow, and if you enjoyed today's video. Like and share my content if you do find it useful, and of course subscribe to Satori Graphics if you haven't done already. I'm here 4 days a week, commonly Monday to Friday. Most of the times it's Monday, Tuesday, Thursday and Friday, with my day off being Wednesday. Also, give me your suggestions for future videos and your opinions on my channel. I take pride in making my content useful for you guys to learn and pick up skills using Adobe Illustrator and other various things in graphic design. So guys, until next time, design your future today. Peace.